When solving a rational equation, the main goal is to determine what expression to multiply both sides of the equation by to eliminate the fractions. And this is going to be the least common denominator or least common multiple of the denominators. So looking at our first example here, since we have a denominator of x and a denominator of x minus 4, the least common denominator would be the product of x and x minus 4. So in general, we're going to find the LCD and then multiply both sides of the equation by this expression. But these two examples are special cases. Since we have one fraction equal to another fraction, we could take a shortcut and cross multiply, meaning the quantity x plus 4 times the quantity x minus 4 must equal 6 times x. But just to keep it consistent, on this example, I'm going to go ahead and just multiply both sides of the equation by the LCD. So we have the quantity x plus 4 all over x equal to 6 over the quantity x minus 4. I'm going to go ahead and put these in parentheses here. Now we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by this expression. So we'll have x times the quantity x minus 4 over 1 times x times the quantity x minus 4 over 1. Notice on the left side we have a factor of x over a factor of x. This simplifies to 1. And on the right, we have a factor of x minus 4 over a factor of x minus 4. So now we're left with the quantity x minus 4 times the quantity x plus 4 equals 6 times x. Again, notice how this result would be the same as cross multiplying here and here. Now we'll eliminate the parentheses and solve for x. So we'll have x squared plus 4x minus 4x, that's 0, minus 16 equals 6x. We have a quadratic, so we'll set it equal to 0 and see if it factors. So we'll subtract 6x on both sides. So now the right side will be 0. This will factor. Factors of x squared are x and x. Now we want the factors of negative 16 to add to negative 6, which would be negative 8 and positive 2. So the values of x that make these factors equal to 0 are x equals 8 from this factor, or x equals negative 2 from this factor. Now before we say these are our solutions, we need to go back up to the original equation just for a moment. Remember, division by 0 is undefined, so our denominators can never be 0, meaning x can never equal 0. X also can't equal 4, because it would make this denominator equal to 0. Since neither of these values are the solutions we found, these two solutions are correct. Now let's take a look at our second example. Again, because we have a proportion here where we have two fractions equal to each other, we could just cross multiply, meaning 4 times the quantity x plus 3 must equal negative 2x times the quantity x minus 7. But let's just review how we would do it if we had additional terms in our equation. We would first find the least common denominator, which would be the quantity x minus 7 times the quantity x plus 3, and then we'd multiply both sides of the equation by this product. But for this example, let's take the shortcut and cross multiply. So again, 4 times the quantity x plus 3 must equal negative 2x times the quantity x minus 7. Again, just keep in mind this only works when we have a proportion where one fraction equal to another fraction. Now we'll clear the parentheses and solve for x. So we'll have 4x plus 12 equals, and on the right side we'd have negative 2x squared plus 14x. Again, notice how we have a quadratic equation, and since we want the squared term to be positive, let's go ahead and add 2x squared to both sides. And since we want the right side to be 0, let's go ahead and subtract 14x at the same time. So on the right side, this is 0, this is 0. On the left side, we have 2x squared. Here we have 4x minus 14x, that's minus 10x. And then we have plus 12. Here we have a common factor of 2. Let's factor that out. We're left with x squared minus 5x plus 6. Equals 0, and looks like it will factor. We have x and x. The factors of 6 that add to negative 5 are negative 3 and negative 2. So it appears our solutions are x equals 3 or x equals 2. But let's go back and make sure these don't make the denominators equal to 0. Back at the original equation, we know if x was 7, we'd have a denominator of 0 in this first fraction. And if x was equal to negative 3, this denominator would be equal to 0. So those are our excluded values. Neither of these occurred in our solution. Therefore, our two solutions here are valid. We'll look at some more examples in the next video.